Very good morning to students. Today we are going to discuss about the part of the mine environmental engineering, mine friction, how the resistance is developing. These things regarding the distribution of the mines. Around 50 minutes lecture we are going to learn today. We know this is the open cast mine image. This is when the surveying going on, ventilation surveying, that image is showing here. Well, the mine environmental engineering, distribution of a miner, the loss of the mine infections. So, that is very important for particular calculations of the orifice calculations, extra. The important loss we are going to discuss in this 50 minutes lecture. On completion of this topic, we would be able to state the loss of mine air friction. Loss of mine air friction. Ventilation is the process of conducting adequate flow of pure fresh air along airways, working places, service points, underground. The main purpose is to provide oxygen for mine worker, but it is also essential to dilute concentration of the explosives and toxic gases, fumes, and reduce them to environmentally safe levels, and to remove from the mine by distribution of fresh air. While supplying the air in underground, the roadways should be kept smooth and allow the air to pass freely up the last point of working place. That is our motto of the mine ventilation system. The friction resistance in roadways should be reduced. That is a major important factor to reduce the then only the air can be reached sufficiently quantity to the other end of the working places. The number of roadways should be reduced. That is one major point. The number of roadways are increased to supply fresh air in each and every place in the mine. By splitting and or connecting either in the series or parallel according to the requirement. Mine condition to keep the miner always in comfortable condition. That is a prime motto of the distribution of the mine air purpose. The loss of mine air frictions. What are the loss are there in related to mine air friction? In underground mine, air should pass without any obstruction. In underground mine, air should be passed without any obstruction. The physical elements like pressure, velocity of air, cross-sectional area of roadways, rubbing surfaces of roadways, they play a vital role in supplying air freely and smoothly throughout the mine. So these are the when air is going to mine, there will be a just like pressure dropping, and also the air will be the smooth surface is not there. This is rubbing surface of air. These are the obstacles for the when the air is going in the galleries. Law one. What is the first law? The ventilation required to overcome the friction resistance varies directly as the area of the rubbing surface of the area, that is a yes, perimeter into length is directly proportional. That means PG directly proposed to S, where S is the perimeter of the particular gallery. That is a very important. The pressure is directly proportional to the periphery. Number law two. The pressure required to overcome frictional resistance varies. The square of the velocity of air current, with the P directly proportional to V. These two are the laws of air friction. Law 3. What is the mean by law 3? The pressure required to overcome the frictional resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area of the airway. So this is also very important. When the cross-sectional area is opposite of cross-sectional area, there is inversely proportional to 1 by A. And law 4. The pressure required to overcome the frictional resistance is directionally proportional to the coefficient of friction of the roadway. That is a P directly proportional to K, where K is the frictional resistance, a constant. Atkinson equation. J.J. Atkinson, combining these four laws, drew on the equation called the Atkinson equation as follows. P is equal to S KS V square by A or KS Q square by A cube. So this is a standardized formula for the calculation of pressures in a different parts of the mine. These two are very useful for the calculation purpose. Whenever you know S required for the pressure and how much surface area we can be calculated, and also area of the particular location can be calculated, velocity can be calculated with the Atkinson principle. The P is equal to KS V square by A or KS Q square by A cube is the Atkinson principle. Where, what is the mean by P? Pressure in kg per centimeter square or mm of water gauge. We can be measured in Pascal or in water gauge, mm, millimeters. K equal to constant depending upon the type of airways. K is a constant depending upon the type of airways. S equal to total rubbing surface area. Total rubbing surface area in meter squares. That is very well. Capital Q is equal to quantity of air. Meter cube per minute. Quantity of air is equal to meter cube per minute. Capital A, cross-sectional area in meter square. Cross-sectional area in meter square. When two surfaces come into contact with each other, the frictional forces is developed. The air to be sent into the underground should overcome the frictional forces, which is developed when the air come into contact with the various objects. We need to calculate this factor while designing the ventilation network for a mine. When a air passes in a mine, it has to overcome the friction of the walls of the shafts, the floor, the roof and sides of the roadways, the props, bars, and other objects in the passage. This is a what are the obstacles in the, while air is going into the galleries or headings. These are the obstacles you can be adding. The wall of the shaft, this will be smooth in nature, but it is not possible in always. The floor, so not in smooth in nature, roof and side of the roadway, the props, bars, and other objectives in the passages. Other stoppings are there, the gutters are there, any machinery's movement are there, cables are there, transformers are there, pumps are there. These are also obstacles to movement of the air. Automatically, it will resist the things. Please note down these things. Then the walls of the shafts. If the diameter of the shaft is more than the friction that has to overcome by the air is more. So that is very important. The floor. If the width of the floor is more than the friction that overcome by the air is more. So these two are the factors you see. Roof and sides of the roadways. Roof and sides of the roadways. If the dimension of the roadways are more, then the friction that has to overcome by the air is more. If the if there are more supports and other obstructions, then the friction that has to overcome by the air is more. factors affecting the minor friction. What are the factors to be considered? The ventilation pressure, that is a Pascal in a kg per meter cube, the difference pressure between the ends of the circuit considered, or the pressure drop that occurs as the air flows through the circuit. Neglecting any change of pressure that is due merely to the change of level or altitude. The cross-sectional area of the airway in meter squares, the coefficient of friction K is normalized between 0.01 and 0.02 newton seconds per meter cube. This is a mark is can say rubbing surface. The area of the rubbing surface is meter square indicated as. The velocity of current V is a normal expression in meter square, meter per second. So these are the general dimension, SI dimensions we note down. Here is not using small m. And similarly, if two exact similar fans are set in working separately on two different mines and run them at the same speed, they will not cause the same quantity of air flow through the each mine due to the difference of resistance to the air flow in different mines. Similarly, resistance mine cause more air flow through them. So this is a unique difference between any two fans or standard fans you're using in one mine. If you take same to the quantity, you can expect not because of the nature of the roadways and other factors are the influencing. Equivalent orifice. What is the mean by equivalent orifice? The equivalent orifice of mine is the area of an imaginary opening in a thin plate, which offer the same resistance to the passage of air as offered by the mine itself. It is the area of opening through which would pass the same quantity of air as it passes through the mine under the same pressure. A mine high resistance is represented by a small equivalent orifice and low resistance by large equivalent orifice. A mine plate is chosen so that it would offer no frictional resistance to the passage of air. The whole of the ventilating pressure being expanded in a producing velocity. The theoretical volume of the air that flows through an orifice depending upon the area of the opening and on the velocity of the air flow. Friction being neglected and velocity resulting from the effective ventilating pressure in a meters of air column is given by the expression. So the following is the expression: velocity equal to square root of 2gh meters per second, where g is the acceleration due to the gravity, this is 9.8 meters per second, so standardized, where h head of air column causing flow in meters. So theoretical quantity of flow through the an orifice is given by q is equal to area into velocity, that is instead of v we write as a square root of gh, so that there is a meter cube per second, there is a quantity of the getting in the through the orifice, where a is area of the opening of the square, that is a particularly in a regulators can calculate purpose you can. So now another important is the vena contractor is one of the important to increasing the pressure. V shape just like water and flowing to the water, the V notch is there. The automatical speed is increasing. Similar way, the air the V notch V vena contract to providing when the liquid is discharging through the air hole in a thin plate, the suctional jet contracted after the passing through the aperture. When air is driven through the air hole in a thin plate, there is a similar contraction. So passing through the orifice, that jet or air convergences or contracts somewhat in area, the contracted section is known as a vena contracts. With circular orifice, the area of the vena contract is about 0.65 of the area of the orifice, and the figure 0.65 is known as the coefficient of the vena contracta. So it can be see this in figure, just like water, the air is also some sudden cropping of area to void area. That is the vena contracta separation of the flow. This is showing the vena contracta. V2 is greater than the V3, where flow of the separation of the at corners. And then formula for the equivalent orifice. Therefore, actual quantity of flow through the orifice, the Q equal to 0.65 area into root V, that is the AV. Equivalent orifice can be A is equal to multiplied by, divided by the 0.65 upon by square root GH, square meters. So ultimately, where P is a pressure in a kg of meter square. W is a density of the water, also density of the air can be take it to any case. Then the simple calculations I was given here, go through it. We can calculate pressure is equal to resistance into quantity square. We can get directly pressure from that. We can be calculate the resistance also. So MK system, we can use this equivalent orifice. Q is a quantity of air flow, P is a pressure absorbed, kg for meter square. This is a formula, but in case of SI units it is different. Okay, R is the resistance in kilo mark. The standardized formula is N square meter square of minus H. So SI units you can be write it as a orifice A equal to equivalent orifice equal 1.2 quantity by square root of pressure, that's a meter square area of we will get it. A is the equivalent orifice, Q is a quantity of air flow, meter square per second, P is equal to pressure absorbed, pascals, R equal to resistance, kilomers, or N square meters. So this is the formula. Problems on equivalent orifice. You can be write the one for problems here. A 200 meter long wall face is ventilated by the two gate rods, each of 300 meter long. A 200 meters long long wall face is ventilated by the two gate rods, each of 300 meters long. Calculate the quantity of the air that will flow along the face when the ventilating pressure of 150 pascals is applied across the gate rods at the outbound. Also find the equivalent orifice of the face if it has a resistance of 0.6 newton second square meter for 100 meter length, negative leakage between the gate rods. So this is a simple problem of I think 200 meter long wall face is ventilated by two gate rods, each 300 meter long. Calculate the quantity of air that will flow along the face, and the ventilator pressure is 150 pascals. So pressure is given, resistance also given. So we have to calculate the quantity, the Q value we have to calculate here. So observe the problem, note down, and next we solve this problem. then solution is given. Length of long wall face equal to 200 meters. That is also given. Length of each gate road is equal to 300 meters. Length of each gate road. Length of each gate road is 311. Pressure of air 150 pascals. Resistance of the roadway is already given. Marks. Right. For each one how much. So equivalent ORF and equivalent ORF is you have the area you have to calculate. Let us go to the problem. Quantity of air can be calculated. PR is square. So Q is equal to square root of P by R. From which we can be calculate. So square root of 150 upon by 1.2. So 11.13 meter cube is a equivalent ORF. So then the area of the ORF is equal to 1.2 by square root of resistance in the meter square area. So get the, this is the answer. From the 1.094 meter square is area. The simplest formula for the practicing purpose, you can be observed the calculation equivalent ORF. Similarly, we go through second problem also. See here. Calculate the equivalent ORF of mine in which 30,000 meter cube per minute of air passing at a pressure of 6.25 mm of the water gauge. Solution given values. Quantity of air 30,000 meter cube per minute. 30,000 divided by 60, that is a PM in seconds. Pressure equal to 625 kgf per meter square or mm of water gauge. Equivalent ORF is A is equal to 0.385 cube square root of B S cube meters. It's given here. The value is getting 7.70 meter squares. Then, now I go to the other laws. The law of governing the passage of air in a mine. The pressure P required work on the friction is directly proportional to the rubbing surface. That is already given. Just recollecting the, these are the laws to be borne in mind always to various problems to encounter to problem solving purpose. Perimeter of air vane, length of the meter cube. Already given law 2 also given here. The pressure P required to overcome the friction directly proportional to the square of the velocity. And also law 3 proportional to 1 by a cross sectional area. The pressure P required to overcome friction varies as the nature of the rubbing surface, or other words, as the coefficient of friction. P directly proportional to K, where K is the coefficient of friction. The law of minor friction, where first and J.J. Atkinson in 1855. So this is Atkinson principle. Already we have gone through with this one. The law is important because they are show as now ventilating shape and size always affecting the ventilation of the mine. Whilst the equation enables us to calculate the precise effect of the particular cases. Before air can flow along on an airway or around a circuit comprising series of airways, there must be a difference of pressure between the end of the airway or circuit concerns. This difference of pressures is called the ventilation pressures. These are the important. Producing the ventilation and is expanded in the overcome the frictional resistance of the airway. In fact, the ventilating pressure is a measure of a frictional resistance, and the greater the resistance, the greater must be ventilated pressure or water gauge required to overcome it. In practice, we endeavor to reduce the friction of the air in every possible way so as to reduce the ventilation pressure per square meters of sectional area to minimum of for a given quantity of air, or to increase the quantity circulating by the given water gauge. The frictional resistance met by the air depending upon the dimensions, area, length and perimeter of the airway itself, and also on the nature of the roadway, on the velocity of the air itself, and also on the nature of the roadway along with which the air passes. Pressure The air is to be sent into the mind. The air to be sent to the mind should have a certain pressure due to the pressure difference between the two places. The air should be traveled from one place to another. Therefore, great care must be taken against the places where there is a pressure drop. The pressures of air, depending on the resistance of the roadway and quantity of air that is flowing through the roadway. Quantity of air, the amount of air required depends on the quantity of dust rising at the face and roadways, the amount of heat generated at the workings, the amount of moisture present at the workings, the quantity of different poisonous gases present. So these are the also the amount of air required depending on some places you require more temperature, some more humidity is there. So which area, how much quantity we were to sending is there? These are the factors are important brought into mind. One is the quantity of dust rising at the face and roadway. That is the most important. The amount of heat generated at the working places. That is important. The amount of moisture present at the workings. That is also important. The quantity of different poisonous gases. So these are the important. Resistance. When the air passes in the mind, it has overcome the friction of wall of the shop, floor, roof and sides of the roadway and props, bars and other objects of the passages. So, relation between the pressure, resistance and quantity. So, P is equal to R square is standardized relationship between the pressure and quantity. Where is R is the resistance. So, R is depending on the different factors. So, general pressure in air, kg per meter square, that is a Pascal. Resistance of the air wave, that is a kilo mark. Q is a quantity of air flowing, that is a meter cube per second. 1 kilo mark equal to, very important, the 1 kilo mark can be written as a 1000 marks. So, 1 mark is equal to 0.0981 newton per second square. M to the power of minus, you have to note it. The 1 kilo mark is equal to 1 dispatch. It's 9.81 newton second square. These are the general relationship between the standardized formulas. Please note down. Formula for determining values of pressure, velocity, coefficient of friction, area of cross section, quantity and area of rubbing surfaces. According to Atkinson equation, the pressure over the pressure overcoming the friction can be calculated as P is equal to Ks V square by A or P is equal to Ks Q square by A. Where we know that Q is equal to VA, V is equal to Q by A. Well, P is equal to pressure observed, kg per meter square or mm of water gauge, kg coefficient of friction, S is the rubbing surface area, the perimeter into length, V is equal to velocity of air, area of the cross section roadway, Q is quantity of air flowing. The coefficient of friction, kilo marks, smooth lined roadways depending upon the surface area, brick and concrete lining is have the value of K 0.00216. Unlined roadway in sediment rocks are poor 0.0118. Shaft and brick lined 0.0618. Stable pit without bottom. So these are the general standardized coefficient of frictions. Methods of reducing mine air resistance. Shaft should be a large diameter, smooth lined and fitted with rope guides to eliminating obstructing buttons. The fan drift should be ample area and arranged to give streamlined flow from the upcast shaft to the fan inlet. Main underground roadways should be large, straight, and the uniform area, the smooth lining, steel arch filled in between with flash brick or concrete. The timber roadways should have the pack walls between the timber sets to give the conditions approximating a smooth surface roadway. All bend should be a large radius. The roading of right angle elbow approximately having a resistance of the bends. In underground mine, there are many roadways as is the coal seam. The air has to be supplied to all the roadways. The air from main roadways has to distribute to other roadways in series connection or parallel connection. There are certain advantages by using series connections methods. So, and there are certain advantages of using parallel connections. So now you're going to overall, so far you're telling pressure, quantity, resistance, what are the relations, different surface areas, perimeters, surface area, these are the in previous slides you understand. But now you go to the when the air is going in a series, when air is parallel, what is happening? That's you are going to learn. So effect of the mine airway in series and parallel. Series roadways, when the airway, when the airways or splits are connected in a series, the volume of flow rate quantity or quantity of air flow in the same in each branch, but resistance R and the pressure P will vary. So series, this R1, R2, R3, the P1, P2, P3. So there is a P, pressure is added. If three, the quantity is going, the three resistance in the P is added. So P is equal to RQ square. So P is equal to, this is a pressure dropped between these two. This is called a series connection. Then airway in series, Q is equal to volume of flow rate. Airway in series, Q capital Q is the volume of a rate. P1, P2, P3 equal to pressure in the airway. 1, 2, 3. So R1, R2, R3 is the resistance in the airway. That is 1, 2, 3. So capital P is a total pressure drop. So this is a when the series, when the air is going series, what are the droppings? You can observe here. Then if you say parallel roadways, the quantity is coming, but they are the independent to each roads. So what, this is the pressure drop. This is a point Q1, Q2, Q3. So now parallel connections, right on the wall diagram. Then, parallel connections between the airways or splits occurs in the ventilation network, where the airway branch at one point and rejoin at another. In this case, pressure drop P is a common to each parallel airway, whereas the resistance R and quantity of airflow Q will be varied. Airways in parallel, R1, R2, R3, resistance in airway, 1, 2, and 3. Q1, Q2, Q3, quantity of airflow in airways, 1, 2, and 3. This is the total quantity of airflow. This is the total pressure drop. You can take it as a in between these two. This is one simple example I am showing the how the series and parallel networks. This is a shaft, intake shaft, and also this is 1. And 2 total intake is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's such a way that is. So, from the main ventilation schematic shown in the figure below, assuming the resistance for each airway is to be 5.0 into 10.10 in meter square per feet square, but actually you have to use SI units, so go for 0.559 newton per second square. For page and the total mine air quantity to be 1 lakh, that means meter cube per second, 47.13 meter cube per second. They given is a quantity in SI units. Determine the total equivalent resistance, the total mine static head, and a quantity of Q that flow through the each airway, assuming natural splitting. This is a generalized formula for the when the mine in the different series never parallel connection, the quantity how to go, it can be calculated by the generalized formula. In the underground mine, there are many roadways, as is the coal seam. The air has to separate in all roadways. The air from the mine roadway has to distribute other roadway, series connection, manner in parallel connection. There are certain advantages by using series connections method, and there are certain advantages by using parallel connection methods. So this is the roadway connecting to series. Q is a constant, P is equal to charge, R is also changes. We know that P is equal to R square. So P is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. P is equal to PR1Q square, P2 is equal to R2Q square, P3 is equal to R3Q square, P is equal to RQ square. By distribution equation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 5 equation, we get the RQ square is equal to this is the formula, you get it, RQ square is total. So R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. This standard is formula for the calculation purpose. Then where R equal to total resistance or combined resistance, R1, R2, R3 are the resistance in airway 1, 2, 3 respectively, the P is equal to total pressure drop. P1, P2 is equal to P3, pressure drop in splits 1, 2, and 3 respectively, huge quantity of airflow. Roadways connecting to in a parallel, let P is equal to constant, Q is a changes, R is a changes. We know that P is equal to RQ square. Well, we have given a excellent formula for that one. For split 1, split 2, and split 3, from standardized formula. Coming to the, when you know that total quantity is P1 plus Q2, Q3, by substituting these things in generalized formula, so the pressure is same in all splits. So finally we get 1 by R square is equal to 1 by root R1, R2, R3, R3. So where R is equal to total resistance or combined resistance, R1, R2, R3 are the resistance in airway, 1, 2, 3 respectively, Q is equal to total quantity of air, Q1, Q2, Q3 is equal to quantity of air in splits, 1, 2, 3 respectively, P is equal to total pressure dropped. So in the underground mine, there are many roadways to assess the coal seam. The air has to be supplied to all the roadways. The air from main roadway has to be distributed to other roadways in series connections or parallel connections. The air has to be split or divided in order to distribute the different parts of the mine. The manner of splitting is explained here. So this is a DC shaft, this is a UC shaft. So it can be split into 3 times. So that problems are already. This is called a splitting of the air, because mine have the different working places, different methods is going on. According to that, air can be distributed in 2 headings, 3 headings, 5 headings, That is a things. Then splitting to supply the fresh air to all the working places in underground is the required quantity. The splits of our airway are made, whether they may be connected in series or parallel, depending on the mine condition. As splitting supplies fresh air to each ventilating district, the overall resistance of the mine is reduced for the same water gauge produced by the fan and same HP developed by the motor in mine. Large number of splits results in proportionally less quantity in each district and consequently reduce the velocity, which may not be able to clear of gas or may not provide adequate ventilation to the districts. The number of splits should be such that the air velocity is not unduly low and that ventilation is adequate as defined as the mining regulations. As far as practicable, all the splits should be same resistance, but some splits may be required to carry more air because of its extensive working phases or more gas emissions. In underground mine, there are many roadways to be assess the coal seam. The air has to be supplied to all the roadways. The air from the main roadway has to be distributed to the other roadways in series connections manner or in a parallel connection. The air has to split or divided in the order to distribute to the different parts of the mine. The splitting has many advantage over the other merits of splitting. A much larger total quantity of air is circulated through the mine for the same expenditure of pressure and power. Purer air, fresh air is supplied to each district, and district haulage roads can be ventilated by the intake air. The percentage of fire damp of the air at the face is reduced. This is one advantage of splitting. An explosion is more likely to be limited to one district unless extended by coal dust. Air velocities are reduced both in the roadway and at the face. So reduce the frictional resistance and also helping to prevent dust being raised in the air. One or more splits may be regulated where necessary to supply a proper proportion of the air to be various districts. Neighboring splits are not adversely affected by the derangement of ventilation, a fall of the roof in the other type of causes. In underground mine, there are many roadways as to local seam. Air has to supply to all the roadways. This is which is already learned here. So what is the ideal conditions of splitting? Fresh air can be supplied to each and every part of the underground mine, where poor air to be ventilated in underground districts, where fire damp accumulation and fumes developed after blasting due to the dilute and cleaned by the sending those gases of the return airway, where coal dust is a more liable and safeguard against explosion to keep the air velocity in adequate capacity between 2 to 3 meter per second to keep the miners always in a better workable condition or comfortable condition. Thereby, rate of accidents will be less and the productivity as well as production. Limitation of the splitting. Care must be taken that the air velocity of the face is not so much reduced that it is a sufficient dilute, and care away noxious and inflammable gases, and keep the working places cool and comfortable. It is generally accepted that the air velocity on a long fall phase should not be less than 50 meters per minute. There is one important note here. Depending upon the conditions of the method, the air velocity had to maintain. Otherwise, rising of the dust results problem is rising. Yes, with this, I'm going to conclude one more point I noted here. And when the phase has to be cleared and to order to ensure the comfortable working conditions and clean away dust and short firing fumes. On the other hand, the air velocity on the face should not be exceed 160 meters per minute, that is 3 meters per second. When the pack wall have been built or conditions become uncomfortable for the man and dust concentration in the air may be become too high. So this is the about the so far learned about the mine resistance, mine friction distribution in the different splitting and narrow series, and also the worked examples of the equivalent of calculations. These are the with this I'm going to conclude that one. We are expecting some quiz questions in the coming ESET and competitive examination, which are giving some questions. Go through it. Ideal conditions for splitting of air is to keep the air velocity between 0.75 to 1 meter per second, between 1.2 meter second, between 0.5 to 0 meter second, between two. So ideal condition of splitting of air, keeping the air velocity, should be a proper maintained. Otherwise, recirculation is problem, dust rising is problem is there. This is one of good question on the air quantity. Merits of splittings. Larger total quantity of air is circulated. Purer air and fresh air is applied to each district. The percentage of fire damp in the air at the face is reduced. So all the above. These are the conditions for that. The purpose of splitting is to supply the fresh air to all the working places, to supply the return air to the all the working places, to increase resistance of the airway, all the above. The purpose of splitting is to supply the fresh air to the all the working places, to supply the return air to the all the working places, to increase the resistance of the airways. So this is the all the above is the correct answer for getting splitting advantages is concerned. And then the formula for total resistance in a series, which is formula for the total resistance in series cases, not in a case 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, 1 by R3 is there. R equal to R1 plus R2, P equal to P1, this is none of the. Which one is correct? So series is which is formula you are using. Go for a reference, series cases. So this is a series. So that is a wrong. Nothing is there. So this is for the series and connecting series. So this is the formula applied. So this is the original results. So by this you can be answered the objective. Similarly, in parallel case, 1 by root R1 is equal to 1 by root R1 R plus R2 R3. Next, effect of mine air in series, quantity of air flow in the same, resistance is same, pressure is in the same. So, quantity of air is flowing in the same, resistance is same, effect of mine air in series. Coefficient of friction of the K value of the shaft brick lined. So we are given different materials, different resistance is there. According to you have to choose the K value. The value of K for smooth lined roadway is 0.0216. The relation between the pressure, resistance and quantity is P equal to RQ square is standardized procedure. So from which we can be calculate all these things. So the relation between pressure, resistance and quantity is P equal to RQ square is correct answer. P equal to RQ square. In the following equation, fill in the missing factor, P is equal to dash. Is the following equation right or wrong? P is equal to KSV square by A cube. So this is wrong. what is the modified form from the Atkinson equation? B equal KS K square by A cube modification. So these are will be coming in exam. So you have to stand and thoroughly know the Atkinson principle. This is very important for the friction calculation purpose. Then law one is what is P direct proportional to V, P direct to Q, Q is direct to S, P is equal to R. What is the law? What is giving the law? You will go to the first step. Let's see here. Yes. Yeah. First law is the P direct proportional to S. That is a surface area, periphery. Showing the periphery. So P is directed to C is a correct answer as per the law is concerned. Where is the law is concerned? Similarly, law 4 is showing that here. Yeah, similarly, which factors are affecting the mean air friction? Cross-sectional area, the coefficient of friction, the area of rubbing surface, all the other. So these are the question. Another question is there here. That is the last one. Pressure required to overcome the frictional resistance is directly proportional to the square of the velocity. Pressure required to overcome the frictional resistance is inversely proportional to the area of the road. So these are the questions you can expect it from the objective point of view in your coming examinations also. So I hope that you are enjoyed today's lesson. I wish you all the best. Thank you.